Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the section tricks and tips, and I will explain you a couple of tricks more on how to use and define the use of GPUs on your local applications, and also when you are working with the Dockers and all these kind of configurations that usually, in my experience, create a lot of problems. When you especially try to attach the GPUs not only available on in your local environment, also when you are working on Dockers or when you are working with a server that where the application is deployed when it's running in production. First of all, I think we explained this before. It's just checking if your GPU is available and correctly configured in PyTorch. It's just a very simple command just to check if your GPU is available. It is return true as the conditional statement is stating here. It is returning GPU available. This you can be use it and send it later to the map of the device that you are going to load your model, and send CUDA or CPU depending what is available in your system. For many cases, as you also may know, it's not possible to run the models even for inference if you don't have a GPU available. Let's give you an example. If you have an LLM that you fine-tune or you train with vFlow 16 or with FFlow 16 or with INT8, if you don't have a GPU available, you will be unable to load the model. So it's important to have the CUDA toolkit, the drivers correctly installed, and so on and so forth. It's not, you are not going to be able even to do inference with the model that you probably train in another environment, or you got from Hugging Face website and you just replicate a model or copy a model of the last model from there. So it's important to have this correctly set up and know how it works when you move the code environment to environment, because it's not too later on we have problems. Other thing that you need to know how to check, here if you have the CUDA toolkit correctly installed, you will be able to run NVIDIA SMA. It will give you the first of all the version of your CUDA toolkit, which is very important in order to set up correctly the version of the PyTorch or TensorFlow Keras that you want to install, or Numba or Cupid, whatever application which is using CUDA. You need to know exactly the support of the NVIDIA that you have installed in your machine. Advice, or just a small note here, no? If you had a GPU which is not from NVIDIA or Tesla, for example, Intel GPU, which is also available, you may find a lot of issues when not impossible to run applications. So when you have to choose which kind of GPU install or select for your final inference or training infrastructure, be careful and read the list of the compatibilities that your library or your application have with different GPU providers and libraries that you are going to use, because it's not, again, it will be even impossible to train or to use the GPU that you choose or you had installed in your server. This is crucial, probably not for the cloud environment, but when you are working on premise, as is the case I usually do in many projects, because you are setting a system from the government or for defense Usually these environments doesn't have NATO as well, doesn't have access most of the system to internet. They had all the infrastructure in on premise, and then you need to install your application, or you need to deploy your server or your software into an infrastructure which is not what you find in your lab, in your what you usually train your model. It's a very specific infrastructure, and you need to be very, very sure how you are going to deploy your application. That's what I'm telling you this, no? Because it's very easy to deploy an application and to make the work PyTorch or TensorFlow in a Google Colab notebook or in your local environment. When you move this to a production environment, the problems just start. Okay, you can check the CUDA toolkit that you had with NVIDIA SME, and then on. In my case, when I try to create a Docker file or a requirements txt file to set up my software, I just first of all look at the version of the CUDA toolkit I have, and then on I prepare my Docker file. My Docker file always have in this case is I'm creating an application which had Olama and well PyTorch transformers, etc., etc., and then on where I had my requirements file, and at the end I installed Torch with all the components. And here is a little bit the trick, no? I had, if you remember, a CUDA toolkit 12.1. Always I use a version which is either 12 the same that the CUDA toolkit, or one is one or two or three versions behind. Always they are gonna work, especially as close as the version that you have in CUDA toolkit is gonna work. Maybe they don't have to say solve all the bug fixes that are corrected in the latest versions and not are using the resources the same with the same efficiency, but they are gonna work. What is never gonna work is if you had a CUDA toolkit 1.18 and you install a PyTorch with support for CUDA 12.1. So having CUDA toolkit with a latest version and you install a PyTorch with a previous one, potentially, well, 90% of the times is gonna work, especially if the versions are close. Vice versa, never gonna work. What more? Once you have your PyTorch installed and if you are gonna run, as you see here, and this is a Docker file. If you try to later on create a Docker compose, I recommend you to do this. Deploy always the Docker container in your Docker compose with a support GPU. Reserve for that specific container a GPU resource. You just need to point out to the driver that the container needs to reserve, and the number of devices that the containers is going to use, and the capabilities are available for that container. If you don't do that, well, it's possible to run it with a command later on, but you may find a lot of issues trying to debug and try to find out where is the problem. This ensures you that later on you don't need to run what I'm going to show you right now. If you run it manually, the container, and it will ensure that at least you are not forgetting any essential configuration when you deploy your Docker, your container to another environment. And finally, if you want to run manually your container with GPU support, you need always to set up this command, no? This parameter, GPU all. If you don't do that, the container is never gonna use a GPU. So you can run the same command with the same port mapping, with the same version of your Docker container, giving a bus, whatever. But if you don't execute, you don't include the parameter GPU all, it can be GPU number, but better to do GPU all, because it will map all the GPUs available in your system, in your environment. If you don't do that, the container will never use, regardless what you do, it will never use a GPU. So don't forget, always either you go and you set up and attach a GPU device in the your Docker Compose, or you just run the Docker with the parameter GPUs equal all. And that's all. I hope that you like the content. I think it's very instructive. It's just basically many problems I found in my daily business. Is I don't try to have to say to patronize anybody. Just I explain you many problems I found in my daily job, in the deployments I'm doing, using neural network, using different libraries, and working in different clients. And then I just want to you want to share with you the problems I had and how I solved it. No, I hope that is helpful for you, and you can take some lesson learned, no, from most of these problems I had in my daily business. And well, if you like it, just give me a like, and if you are not subscribed to the channel, it's now time to do it. Thank you very much.